Hello and welcome back to my channel Code with Ease by Varsha. We are doing a series on coding patterns. In the previous videos, we have discussed about the introduction and overview of coding patterns, what they are, why they are being used, what problems they are trying to solve, how they are being used. So I would highly recommend to check that out. I'm going to link it up in the description below. If someone is learning DSA for the first time or is a working professional who wants to revisit the basics, I think coding patterns comes to the rescue because it gives a holistic 360 degree picture of what you are learning. So it just helps to plan the learning better. And as part of this series, we are going to cover in depth about each and every pattern, what they are, the pattern is, why the pattern is being used, how can we identify such patterns in the questions, look for clues in the questions, what is the underlying technique behind every pattern, and all of that we are going to cover. So I'm hoping this would help many of you guys. So stay tuned, and if you wish to get further updates on this coding pattern series, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon, of course. So without further ado, let's jump right in. The next coding pattern that we will discuss is the in-place reversal of a linked list. So in that, what we have to do, suppose there is a linked list given to us, something like this, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the input linked list that we have. This is the head, as we know, the starting node, and this is the tail node, which points to null. So if this is the input, the requirement is we have to reverse this linked list such that this tail node comes at the beginning, the tail node becomes the new head, and it's just points all the like the and it is just pointing in the opposite direction. So 4 will point to 3, 3 will point to 2, 2 will point to 1, and now 1 will point to null. So this is the output. When we say in place, it means we have to do this reversal in constant space. This is the required space complexity. So this pattern talks about reversing the linked list in a constant space. So why this is a different pattern in itself? Because the concept that we learn over here is applied in different kind of question. So this is a basic pattern, like given a linked list, reverse it. You might also be asked like, okay, given a linked list, reverse it, but reverse it in a certain range. Maybe you'll be told that you have to reverse only the two nodes, 2 and 3. Everything else should remain as is. You might have to, this is something like you are reversing k nodes of a linked list. So you just have to reverse 2 nodes at a time. So it should be something like 2, 1, 4, 3. So these are different flavors of the same kind of question. So this is the reason why we talked about coding patterns. When we understand patterns, we can understand how can we apply the same logic, the same algorithm to different, to similar questions. What is this pattern going to do? And why is it doing? Like it is doing it in constant space, and the head becomes the new tail node, and the tail node becomes a new head node. So that is clear. Now the question arises, how are we actually going to do it, and how are we going to identify this kind of a pattern? Coming to how, what happens in this case is, suppose you have this node. I'll just talk of the first two nodes. This is the current head node. We can use pointers. So when we have to do in place, why it is specifically told in place? Because I cannot use another new linked list and start copying the nodes to the new nodes. Like I cannot create another node and try to establish the new links. So that is why it has been told in place. Means whatever the current pattern is, that 1 is pointing to 2, 2 is pointing to 3, and so on. In that pattern only we have to make sure that the nodes, the next pointer of the nodes get reversed. So if 1 is here and 1 is pointing to 2, if I have to reverse only this much, what is the smallest problem? I have to reverse only this much, which means 2 needs to point to 1 and 1 needs to point to null. This much we understand. So in a basic sense, the next pointer of 1, instead of pointing to 2, it should point to null. So what we can do, we can take another node, we can call it like a previous node. We can initialize a node which is null initially, okay? And then we can store the next value of this in some kind of a temporary node, that okay, 1.next, whatever it is, just store it. Then I can break this link, because if I have stored 2 I can break the link between 1 and 2. Then I will just make sure that 1.next is now actually pointing to this node, which is priv. So link is broken, 1 is now pointing to null. So this much part is done. 1 has been reversed. The link between 1 and 2 is cut off. The same thing will happen for all the other nodes. Now coming to 2 and 3. Similarly, 2 will be pointing now. 2 did not point to null. So the thing is, why I'm taking a priv pointer is, priv pointer, the previous pointer, is always going to point to the previous node of the current node. So if this is a current node, there will be a previous pointer, there will be a current pointer, and there will be a next pointer. So using 3 pointers, we can do in place reversal of the linked list without even requiring any additional data structure. So that is the whole point that we are going to do. Use the 3 pointers in such a way that first you store the value of the next pointer, the next node, then change the next pointer of the current node, and then accordingly traverse. That's it. So this is all about the algorithm for how to reverse a linked list. What is this pattern trying to ask for? And coming to the identification, it's very straightforward. Let's take a look at few of the lead code questions in which we were talking of. You have to reverse a linked list. It is given the head, reverse the linked list and return. This is a very straightforward question in which we can understand at upfront that we have to apply the in-place reversal. Okay. So this is a very straightforward question, and we can understand where we can directly apply this pattern because it is told to reverse the linked list. And if there is a constant of doing it in place, then there is nothing to say. Let's see another variation of this question. So if you notice this question, reverse linked list 2, in this we are given the head of the single linked list and there are two integers left and right, and we have to reverse the nodes of the list from position left to right only. So if we see 2, 3, 4, only this range which we were saying earlier, only a part of the linked list is reversed. So 2, 3, 4 becomes 4, 3, 2, whereas 1 and 5 remains unchanged. So this is what we were talking of. So in this again, if we know how to do in-place reversal of a linked list, the basic pattern, it's very easy to apply the same concept over here with a bit of tweak in the code. Next, if we notice this question, however, reverse nodes in K group. So in this, there's a value K, which is an integer which is given, and we have to reverse the nodes of the list K at a time only. So if we see K is equal to 2, and this is the linked list which is given. So they are doing 2 at a node. So they are doing 2 nodes at a time. 1, 2 is becoming 2, 1. 4, 3 and 4 is becoming 4, 3. So like that. So again, the same thing. If we know how to do in-place reversal, if we know the smallest sub-problem that we have to solve is 1 and 2 will become 2 and 1. How it is becoming 2 and 1? We have already seen that in the diagram. So if we know the basic foundation of how to do the in-place reversal, it doesn't matter whether we have to do it in a range, whether we have to do it for K number of nodes. So this is the reason why these are called coding patterns. And a knowledge of these kind of patterns helps to solve any kind of lead code question, any kind of coding problem, be it easy, medium, hard, doesn't matter. So with that, it's a wrap on the coding patterns for in-place reversal of the linked list. See you guys in the next video.